welcome to Minnesota. It's nice and cold. So you have a busy weekend here. First, why don't you just tell me a little bit about yourself and tell me a little bit about your foundation?
My nonprofit is dedicated to championing the journey to full inclusion in families, schools, the workplace, and the community. And we role model that as well.
So what brings you to Minnesota?
Well, I'm speaking tomorrow night at a gala about building awareness for people with tremendous capabilities and achievements about what we can do, not what we cannot do. You know, like the basic things like graduating from high schools, we can do that. And we just want to, I just want to show that we can do a lot of things that we put our minds and hearts to.
So that is your message for all of these people. What does it mean to you? You have accomplished so much. You are such a role model for these people who are going to hear from you tomorrow. What does that mean to you to be the speaker at such an important gala and a role model for all of these people?
It means a lot to me to be a role model here and just do what I can to think positive. And so I encourage everyone else here to think positive.
Tell me a little bit just about yourself. You are an accomplished swimmer. Man, you could outswim me any day. You could I am just stunned by your list of accomplishments. Tell me a little bit about how you got into swimming and what kind of things you've accomplished.
Well, my dad taught me how to swim at 9 months old. And he's taught swimming in Red Cross before. And so he got me to swimming and open water swimming. So he focused on that. Mom focused on academics. And I stayed dedicated all my life.
That dedication has paid off. I mean, you swam across the English Channel, Lake Tahoe. Mm-hmm. What was that like? What were those experiences like?
Those were really challenging for me, but I got through it. You know, I had a lot of friends out there in Lake Tahoe and the English Channel and from the Boston Harbor. You know, those swims really felt good after completing those swims.
So you have completed endurance swims mm-hmm. and in colder water, but tomorrow you are jumping into ice cold water. It's probably going to be around 0 degrees.
Yeah.
Are you ready?
I am.
What made you decide to do something like that? Obviously, it's for a great cause.
It is for a great cause, and it's for the people at Gigi's Playhouse who really want to make a difference in the world, and I'm here to show that difference.
Are you nervous to jump in cold water?
I'm actually okay with it. If I can jump in Boston Harbor, I can easily jump in Lake Calhoun.
Very impressive because it takes a hardy person to want to jump into a frigid cold lake, but you are doing it for a great cause.
Yeah.
Where are you from?
Portland, Oregon.
So braving the cold waters of Minnesota in the winter, I'm very impressed. But everyone, I'm sure, very much appreciates all that you've done.
Thanks. So,
is there anything else on the agenda for your trip to Minnesota?
Just the lake and speaking. Pretty much, so.
I think that's a lot. It's busy.
Yeah.
Definitely a busy weekend.
Thanks.
Karen, is there anything else you want to add that we didn't really cover that you want to touch on and expand on?
If she asked you, what was your longest swim, what would you say and how would you describe it?
So my longest swim was the English Channel. So it took us over 14 and a half hours. I had two teams of six people, and I did 2 1-hour legs of the swim. Mostly other people did 3 1-hour legs.
And what's the longest that you've swum nonstop?
And nonstop was 9 miles across the width of Lake Tahoe, starting at 6 a.m.
I just have no words for how difficult and challenging and how much you've shown you can accomplish anything. That's incredible.
Thanks.
And very inspiring to a lot of people.
Now people think, you know, looking for you as a role model. Now, who is your role model, you know, when you get to go and Who inspired you to do all this?
My parents did, and my grandfather did.
Yeah.
Really.
How cold was the, can I, do you mind if I ask, just how cold was the Boston Harbor?
The Boston Harbor, I want to say in the 50s.
50-degree water?
Yeah.
But you had a wet
seat. I had a wet seat on them.
So how cold was the English Channel?
The English Channel was 61 in a regular swimsuit.
No
wet suit.
No wetsuits allowed in the English Channel. Do you
right.
Explain why there are no wetsuits in the English Channel?
They're very British back there. Captain Matthew Webb swam in 1875 with regular swim trunks.
So everyone else has to do the
so
same.
So they follow the same rules, yes.
When you are doing things like speaking and doing these endurance and swims, you're thinking about your role models. You're thinking about your parents and your grandparents. What are you thinking? How did they really push you to get to where you are today?
They just encouraged me to do the very best I can, and I'm here to do that, so.
Karen, maybe you can say something about Gigi's Playhouse and why Gigi's
yeah.
Playhouse is so important. What is Gigi's Playhouse trying to do for people with Down syndrome?
You know, Gigi's Playhouse is giving us a voice. They're helping us achieve our highest potential and to build awareness about our achievements and our amazing successes in life.
And when you go talk to parents, of kids with Down syndrome, what do you tell them about your life with Down syndrome? Is there any advice you give or anything that you give as insights?
You know, I just, I help their kids get into swimming by talking about my swimming experiences. They said, I want to get my child into swimming. After seeing what you have done, their kids can do it too.
It's incredible. You've done so much, and you are really a role model for these people, and we appreciate that you took time to come here, and your time to come to Minnesota, and I hope you have a wonderful weekend,
great,
and that you're okay jumping into cold water. Adam, do you have anything else you want to ask?